Detroit. He's excited to be in Arizona. I am coming out of Minnesota where we just melted our last inch of snow. So when the 101 degrees hit me, I was blown away. We're so excited to be out here with all of you. How about one more round of applause for Justin? That was awesome, Justin. Honestly, authenticity is so critical. Everything that he was saying is true. As a speaker, I've always believed that vulnerability equals connectivity. You want to connect with your clients on a more deeper level? Be willing to be authentic. Be willing to be vulnerable. As a speaker, and also, what gives me challenge as a professional singer, I always want to acknowledge the people in the room that make all of this possible. I can't believe a wonderful gentleman, Paul Williams, who mic'd me up, and it's the only reason I sound this good. So, Paul, thank you so much, man, for mic'ing me up. One of the pastors who are setting me up this time. I know Scott really wanted all of you to have the NFL experience. So, the Super Bowl champion, and to honor Scott and AGPI, after the power session, I'll be on the foyer, and if you want, I will take you as far as I possibly can. My career ended due to concussions, and I feel like everybody should experience one so that you can understand what it actually feels like on this game. I don't condone that. Outside of football, what I'm here to talk to you about today, which is the power of championships, chosen culture, and its impact on business, and on why, is the most important part of my life, which is as a husband and a father to four daughters. Yeah, oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I need more than three daughters, okay? I was listening. Pray for me, please. But every single day. Hey, Scott, are we still going to be doing the UTEC wedding donation bucket handout here? Jokes aside, but I'm really excited to be here on this campus, I guess, to talk about the impact of being at a Super Bowl championship team. I'll take it. It's hard to really explain what it's like to go from a small river town of Hastings, Minnesota, with 13,000 people to playing on a world championship field in front of about 120 million people across the world. And it was all because of one man, Hall of Fame head coach Tony Dungy, who was the first to win a championship built on servant leadership. What is servant leadership? Servant leadership is the belief that if you build better men, you get better football players. That if you build better people, you get better performance. This kind of promise, but a lot of nations would call that the soft skill side of life, even though it's the foundation for life. And so to step into that Super Bowl championship locker room, I'll never forget that first team meeting. And Coach Chelsea got in front of 53 of the most talented people on the planet, Peyton Manning sitting in my lap. And he said, "Men, if you're only here because your identity is wrapped up in a sport, you've completely missed it." Remember what you're doing. I've heard from former coaches. And then he said something pretty radical. He said, "Man, my number one job here is to hold a standard." Now, I really looked at all trying to connect with the coaches. I'm just not a coach with my heart. And the acronym for family in football is "Forget About Me, I Love You." The power of selflessness as a principle, as a non-negotiable belief in value. And so what was radical about this is that not only did Coach Dungy talk about these things, but he built out systems in which he actually lived cultural objectives so that we can practice them and develop these qualities in ourselves. It's not just a mission, vision, value statement. It's actually building out an operating system of the non-negotiable belief in value that will guide the behaviors of the team, and ultimately help them to grow this country. Now, we have to be a part of that. I'll never forget, February 4th of 2007, I was in the tunnel, and I was getting ready to run out onto that field. And as I plant my foot on that first and tough, typical grass, I heard this familiar voice crying my name, Bowman! And I turned, and there, almost falling over into the tunnel, was my guide. He had worked his way halfway around, and my woman standing there to be in this silent moment. And wouldn't you believe that my reaction was to swoop away like a piece of paper? I said, "Dad, it's the Super Bowl! I would love to go play in the Super Bowl! No, no, no!" And I took one more step and decided that I was talking about this. And I heard it. I felt this voice to go back to where I was. Go back to the middle of the night. Help you get to where you were because you came to the nonnegotiable belief system that passed this as a young kid. My dad was a pastor, so he always started with, pray for something bigger than yourself. Pray for something bigger than yourself, because that will reach the ball higher than anything that you know. Secondly, never give up. Never give up. There's always somebody that wants your job. Never give up. Third, with hard work, it doesn't work. Don't work every day to get to what you want. And last, and most importantly, is fun. Have fun. Right? If you can't take it all, then it's just a problem. I wanted to give you that example because one of those things that my dad did when he was 3 years is defined as a set of beliefs that guide the behaviors that happen to people. And I'm sure many of you in this room, if you're thinking about it, whether it's a parent or a grandparent or a coach or a friend, or a partner, you can probably remember these nonnegotiables that you will be being told that helps you to get to where you're going, right? Or that you're speaking to the people that you care about the most because you want to know the gospel to get there in the same way, right? Today, the organizational environment around its core of beliefs is central. It is common across psychology to understand that beliefs and values within the human condition of your employees is essential to the foundation of organizational culture. Okay? That's a lot of the incentive. But what you need is going deeper and developing systems like that. Right? The acronym consists of saving self time, energy, money. And it's not just strategic planning to get to your financial goals. It's also strategic planning to get to your human goals. So that every person that comes in the role, every client that you sit down and meet with, your non-negotiable belief system becomes the core of their life. Not to give you the trust. Not to give you the commitment of what you have. It's sustainable. And that's what culture can be. In 1961, the U.S. Bill Gates, which for us is to be the first to put a man on the moon. There's an infamous story of President John Kennedy walking through the halls of NASA, and he comes across a man who is, with all of his might, cleaning that floor to the best of his ability. He introduces himself as the president. And he asks his editor a question. He says, "Mr. Janet, what's your job here?" So I'm speaking of these again, it says, "Mr. President, my job is to put a man on the moon." What you later learned is that was not by mistake. That was a non-negotiable belief that was distributed across the entire organization to make sure that you got that. That whether you were at the storage manager or you were working on the rocket, you shared the same goal. The nature. How you take care of that natural facility is a representation of what it takes to do something that no person has ever done. Fast forward to Dr. Sherman in 2007, the Cold Foods, the Chicago Bears, 29-7 people. So if you were to go around into any department of the Cold organization, whether it's facilities manager, training staff, equipment staff, players, coaches, business administration, all the way up to general care, I'm going to be able to ask the question, what's the job here? Every single person that wanted to take the job, anyone, from facilities management up to the government, completely aligned and unified as a belief system. And ultimately, that's how we define culture. Culture is what you believe, why you believe it, and how you choose to believe it.
That's
workplace culture is critical. And let me close with this story. Culture is designed to my senior year, I was one of the top titans in the country that was up for the National Award of Sustainability and Tax Tight on the Board. And we were playing at that one, three quarters of the way through the season against yourself and back at the morning on a corner route, which is 10 yards straight up the field, 45 degree angle into the end zone. As I crossed my foot and turned to look for the ball, all across my board, I get home. because he was practicing the total belief system that was built on what it would be to have a total and he was practicing the system. We want you to be a cult. We know your vision is spending your time doctor to be a surgery, but at the same time, if you're going to attend, what can you even help this one in the rest? That's 250 million. Here's a $20,000 special bonus to sell. Thank you.